here in St. Louis, Missouri, and as you can see right over there is the Arch. And that's what I will be talking about today. I want to give a brief history and just some interesting facts about the Arch. So, yeah. The Arch is commonly referred to as the Gateway to the West. It is the world's tallest arch and Missouri's tallest accessible building. It was completed in 1965 and it took 2.5 years to build it. In 1965, it cost around $13 million, which would be just over $80 million in today's dollar. It has carbon steel on the inside and stainless steel on the outside, and then it's filled in with concrete on the inside. So it's a very solid structure. It's 54 feet wide at the bottom, and it tapers down to just 17 feet wide at the top. It is also as wide as it is tall, which is 630 feet. It's 630 feet wide and 630 feet tall. Also, when they built it, it was projected that 13 workers would die while building it. But surprisingly, not one worker died while they were building the arch. Now, if you're worried that it might ever fall over, you might want to rethink that once you hear what's holding it down. Each leg is embedded in 23,570 tons of concrete, 44 feet wide, and it goes 60 feet deep. The arch is resistant to earthquakes and is designed to be able to sway 18 inches at the top in either direction. It is also built to withstand winds up to 150 miles per hour. The arch itself weighs close to 40,000 tons. Over 4 million tourists visit the arch each year, with about 1 million of them going to actually to the top of the arch. The top of the arch can hold up to 160 people, and it has 16 windows on each side with views up to 30 miles. There are three ways you can get to the top of the arch. There's stairs, there's an elevator, and then there are also trams that go up inside the legs. In the tram, it takes 4 minutes to get to the top and 3 minutes to get back down. Over its lifetime, around 350 people have either gotten stuck in the tram or at the top, but no one ever died from it or was seriously injured, so it was not critical, they just were stuck for a little bit. The different malfunctions were caused by severed cables and power outages and just electronic malfunctions of some kind, switches or whatever. There have been at least 10 pilots who have illegally flown through the arch, and if you fly through the arch illegally, you will get a fine and your license will be suspended. So it is a pretty big deal. On November 22, 1980, Kenneth Smyers parachuted onto the top of the arch and was going to use his reserve parachute to parachute the rest of the way down, but when he landed on top of the arch, he lost his footing, the wind blew him off or something, and he slid down the one leg of the arch and he died. Also, on September 14, 1992, John C. Vincent used suction cups to climb up the one leg of the arch to the top, and then he parachuted down. And he was not injured, everything was fine. He actually made it up the side of the arch with suction cups, which I thought was pretty cool, but he did get in trouble for it. If you have not come and seen the arch yet, I really recommend that you would. It's a really cool thing. It looks really cool, and it's just a really neat thing. Just the way it's designed, the arch. Yeah, I highly recommend that you come visit it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, leave a like and hit the subscribe button, and I will see you later.